friends, welcome to my next video lesson. So in the previous video lesson we have started a new chapter, that was light, and this is the continuation video. Let's see what we have learned in the previous class. I will just recapitulate the terms or the important topics what I have already taught in my last class, right? So you see, this was a plane mirror, that is XY. The front side is polished and the back side is coated, okay, that is a silver coated here. Now whenever a light falls on the plane mirror, here let us consider AB is the incident light. Now when I say AB, it is incident ray, right? So when an incident ray falls on a plane surface, that is mirror, it gets reflected in the same medium, that is in form of BD, that is BD is the ray of light, reflected ray of light. Now if I draw here one normal passing through a point B, what was point B? Already I have said in last lesson, the point B is called point of incidence, right? So the point at which the incident ray strikes the plane mirror is called the point of incidence. Now when we draw a perpendicular line passing through point B, that is called normal, okay? A normal is a perpendicular line passing through point of incidence. So here normal is N dash, right? Now one thing you note here, whenever an incident ray falls on a plane mirror, it gets reflected in the same medium. Now when we draw one normal, the angle subtended between incident ray and normal, this angle is said to be as angle of incidence. And similarly, the angle subtended between reflected ray and normal is considered as angle of reflection. That means angle of incidence is denoted by I and angle of reflection is denoted by R. So these are the terms we have already learned in my previous classes, right? So you see, if I ask what are the laws of reflection, so there are basically two laws of reflection. So one by one we will see. First law says that the incident ray reflected ray and normal at the point of incidence all lie in same plane, right? So this is the first law of laws of reflection. Let's see what is written here. The incident ray, the reflected ray and normal at the point of incidence all lie in same plane. That means they are lying in the same graph. Okay, so in same 2D plane they are fixed. Now you see, second law says that the angle of incidence must be equals to angle of reflection. That is point number two. Angle of incidence is always equals to angle of reflection. So these are the two laws of reflection. Okay, this question is very important, and whether it be unit test or exam, every time this question generally it comes, and the question based upon this also is very important. The next topic you will see in your screen, that is plane mirror. Now the first question comes, what is a plane mirror? Every object has an ability to reflect light. So whenever a light falls on any object, the light gets reflected and comes to our eyes. Then only that object is visible to us, right? An opaque substance, when it has an ability to reflect the complete light fallen on it, then it can act as a plane mirror. Likewise, if I say this is a plane mirror, that means opaque substance, it is not allowing any light to pass through it. That is why it is opaque, right? So whenever any light is falling here and it is completely reflected here, none of the light is getting absorbed. So we say that this smooth surface is acting like a mirror. Now when I go for the definition, you see, what is mirror here? A flat, smooth, straight piece of glass that is silvered at its back surface is called plane mirror. That means the silver coating must be there. If you don't have a silver coating in the glass, then the glass will not be able to reflect the light completely in the same direction. That means whenever a light is moving from air after striking, the light won't be coming in the air medium. That means the few or some partial amount of light will get absorbed. So it will lose its ability to reflect that light, right? So this plane mirror is used to form the image of any object. So you see in the diagram, I have placed one object here. Now what is object? Object can be anything, like it can be table, it can be chair, which we see around us, they are considered to be as an object, right? So I have considered here one object whose image we want to find from the plane mirror. That means an object is placed in front of a plane mirror and we know the image will be also of same size and at same distance. So that only we are going to prove from this diagram. Okay, so an object is placed here, that is inverted object, that is upside down, one object is placed here. So from the top of that object, two rays will be emerging, that means one will be falling here and other rays will be falling here. These are two are called incident ray. Now as rays are falling on the plane mirror, they will get reflected also. So these are the reflected ray, that means two incident ray and two reflected ray. Now this point, they will converge and they will form an image in the backhand side. That is why whenever we are standing in front of a plane mirror, that is near our dressing table, so we find that our image is formed behind the mirror, right? So you see the convergence of both the reflected light in the backward direction is considered as here image. So I is the image of formed by this object. Okay, now if you measure this distance and this distance, both the distances will be same. This means that the image, the distance from the mirror to the image and the object to the mirror is same. Okay, so let's give one example. Suppose if I consider this as to be a dressing table. Now when I am standing in front of a dressing table, the distance between me and this mirror and the mirror and the image will be same. And the height of the image, that means height of myself in the mirror, will also be same. So these are the characteristics of plane mirror. So we will go one by one. So this was the diagram which we have seen on the board. That means object is placed at O, so it is forming an image at I. The distance of OL and LI is same, right? Similarly, in right hand side you see there is a object, that is PQ, that is a pencil, and from both the ends light is falling on the plane mirror. So after reflection in the backward side, we will find the image of that pencil, that is the virtual image. Okay, so if I ask what type of image is formed by a plane mirror, then you will be saying it is a virtual image. These virtual images are those images which cannot be obtained on a screen. Okay, next we will see the characteristic of images formed by a plane mirror. So first characteristic says that the image formed by a plane mirror is erect. That means if you are standing in front of a plane mirror, then you will not find yourself in the mirror upside down. You will find that an image of yourself in the mirror is also standing. Okay. Second point, image is formed behind the mirror and is same size as the object. Just now I told you that you see in this diagram, this distance between OL, that means you and the mirror, and the mirror and the image, that distances are same. And moreover, their size is also same. So therefore it is said, point number 3, the distance of the object from the mirror is equal to the distance of the image from the mirror. Next, the image formed by the plane mirror is laterally inverted. This is very important, right? So let's see what is lateral inversion. So in the screen you see a boy standing in front of a mirror. So he is raising his right hand, but the mirror is showing his left hand. This is called lateral inversion. Okay, the interchange of left side of an object to as right side of an image, and right side of an object to be as left side of an image. So this change in left and right side of an object and image is called lateral inversion. So the image formed by a plane mirror is laterally inverted. Okay, so what is the definition of lateral inversion you see in the screen? This phenomena in which left appears as right or vice versa in the image of the object formed by a plane mirror is called lateral inversion. Difference between real image and virtual image. Real image
can be obtained on a screen, whereas virtual image cannot be obtained on a screen. Real image is always inverted, that means upside down, but virtual image, that means image formed by a plane mirror, is erect. You see, when a boy is standing in front of a plane mirror, his head and head is in the same side, and the foot and foot, they are also in same side. That's why we say that the boy's image is erect. But if the boy's image is opposite, suppose foot is up, head is down, then we say that type of image as inverted image. So inverted image is formed by the real image, that is by other mirror, but virtual image is formed by the plane mirror. Also, virtual image, it is always erect. The rays actually meet at a point after reflection, that is real image, but in case of virtual image, the rays appear to meet at a point after reflection. The image is formed in front of the mirror, the image is formed behind the mirror. That means the image formed by the plane mirror is virtual, because image is formed in backside. So these are the uses of plane mirror. Plane mirrors have a number of uses. At home, in beauty parlors and barber shop, we use plane mirrors. To make small shops seem larger than they are. That means in jewelry shop also, we place the plane mirror on four walls so that the room look bigger and brighter. Number three, in making periscopes, solar cookers and toys such as kaleidoscope, we use plane mirror. So, or making on the science exhibition and all, we have seen that these mirrors are placed in such an angle and they are used in this type of instruments, that is periscope, solar cookers and toys and kaleidoscope. In measuring instrument, to avoid error while taking readings also. So we use this mirror for taking many accurate readings of an instrument also. Okay, so these are the uses of plane mirror. So the notes which I am showing in the video, you need to write in your exercise book also. You may write the important definition, you may write the properties and the uses of plane mirror, right? So this question you will be drawing in your copy. Observe the figure and answer the question. You see, AO is the incident ray, OB is the reflected ray, and ON is the normal. So answer the following question. Mark I. So in the diagram you have to place I. I means angle of incidence. Mark R. In the diagram again you have to mark angle of reflection. Line segment OA or ON represent in the normal. So you see, in the diagram, which line segment is said to be as normal? I am giving this answer. This answer will be ON. So out of two options, OA and ON, which one is normal? ON is the normal. So similarly, angle AON or BON represent angle of incidence. Angle AON and BON represent angle of reflection. So angle of incidence is between AON, right? And angle of reflection will be BON. Similarly, incident ray is OA and reflected ray is OB. The answer to the above question is one of the laws of reflection. What is the other one? So that means you will write the laws of reflection here. The incident ray, the reflected ray and normal all lie at a same plane. And angle of incidence equals to angle of reflection. So this diagram also you need to make in your exercise book. Image formation of a point image. That means here this object image and the pencil image also you will be making. Image formed by a large object. So this is a point object and this is a large object. Okay, so in the ray diagram, whenever you are making a ray diagram, make sure that you are drawing the arrows. Without arrows, the optics questions will get wrong. Okay, you won't get a full marks if you are not drawing the arrow in the ray diagram. And this true and false also you need to write in your exercise book. Virtual images cannot be obtained on a screen. True or false? Virtual images are always inverted. Images formed by a plane mirror are erect. Images formed by a plane mirror are laterally inverted. And images formed by a plane mirror can be obtained on a screen. So these questions you need to write in your exercise book. And be prepared for your next online test. So after the completion of this chapter, I will be again conducting the test. So all the best for that, and for this video only this much. Till then, bye.